So to get things started, again, with pandas at least, pandas has multiple read underscore something methods that will work for different sources, right? So we saw already read SQL, we've seen read CSV. There's also a read HTML to directly parse information from a table. It's literally, you can just, you pass a website, it's gonna read information from a table, or read JSON, read more advanced formats like Parquet or Stata, etc. And again, each file format will usually have a correspondence in pandas. I've never had the chance to rewrite my own stuff, to be honest. The same thing is going to happen for something like Excel, which might need external modules. It's not directly provided by pandas, but by installing those modules, you can easily incorporate Excel files in your day-to-day work. So the read CSV method has a ton of parameters. So this is the main characteristic of all these read something methods. Given the amount of possibilities that you're gonna have with these files, there exist a ton of different ways to customize the method invocation, right? So again, CSV files, we saw there are multiple things that happen. CSVs that have a header, don't have a header, different delimiters, different enclosing of strings or numbers, multiple things, blank lines, etc. Multiple things are gonna happen, and that's all you're able to customize all that with the read CSV method. So this is the reference of all the attributes you can pass to it. Usually something that I do, and I do this very often, and I use pandas a lot, and I still do something like read CSV, and I get the documentation right in here to look into the parameters that I think I need to pass to my particular use case. So keep an eye always in the docs, because it's impossible to remember all the parameters in the CSV. So in this case, what we're gonna do, it's something very interesting, is we're gonna parse a CSV file, but it's not located in this computer. It's not locally available in the computer. The CSV file is this one right here, which actually is the source. If I get the raw version, is this thing. So this is a CSV file. What I could do here is download the file, right? So just do file, save, get the CSV file on my computer, upload it here, right? So just copy and paste it here, drag and drop it here. But actually pandas has this nice characteristic that it will read a CSV that it's either locally, as we did with BTC Market Price, or it can also do it remotely. It's automatically going to download the content of those files, and it's gonna provide, it's gonna save it in memory for further usage. So this is a very neat feature. And again, this is the CSV file that we are using. And again, the same thing, if it's a local file, it works in the same way. So a few features you've seen already. In this case, we can do a header none, if you don't wanna treat the first row as a header. Or what about missing values? We can treat some of these values, like a question mark, or like an exclamation mark, or a dash, etc., as not a value, right? So it's as a missing value. And now any of these values we have passed will be transformed into a not a number for easier an easier process cleaning. We can pass names, which is gonna be basically the column names for each one, and we can also specify column types, as you can see right there. So now the types are gonna be float and object. We've done this already in one of our lessons. We are parsing the time, and there you go. So putting all together, we get to these advanced forms of reading CSVs, where we're passing column names, we're passing types, we're asking to read dates, we're passing null values, headers, etc. So this is a pretty common thing we are doing. So what about XM review? If we try parsing this thing, we get this very ugly format. In this case, the parameter to specify what we used to call delimiter in CSV is now sep from separator. So the separator is gonna be the greater sign, and that just works as it needs. So a few more examples you can check on here. The most important part is following, right, the documentation to find those particular use cases that you are having. So for example, something like skip blank lines, or whenever there are like empty rows at the beginning, right? So if you have empty rows at the beginning, it's something you can also say skip rows, so you don't need to parse those, it's not gonna break, etc. So that is all part of the read CSV file. And to finalize this part, at least CSVs, I'm gonna tell you something that applies to pretty much every other data format. As you have a read something method, there's gonna be a to something method. It's basically the process of writing. So you can do read CSV or you can do to CSV. So these CSV that we imported from the external source or the remote source, we can just do to CSV and it's gonna store it locally. All right, and there are multiple options also to pass to CSV, the delimiter or actually the separator, if you want to include a header, if you want to include an index, etc. They're pretty much the same as the other one. But the idea is that for every read something method, there's going to exist a to something method that is basically the process of writing. So let's move forward with a few more data formats. And interesting, we're going to get to read directly HTML pages in just a couple of minutes.